yourself, my name is Hope.
Let's go back to you signing up for Furious 6. You sign up for that post-credit scene.
Bam, yeah.
Did you know you were going to be this big a deal in the franchise?
No, you don't. In fact, you don't even know if that tag is going to have any meaning. You just, they said, okay, now we're gonna put you into the part 7 and we're going to give you something to do. So I remember there was a, we had conversations even before 6, where in the latter part of when they'd just finished 5, they wanted me to be in 6. And for some reason the creative wasn't right for me, so they put me on at the end, and here we are, like, you know, in the spin-off, all these years later. It's great to think that, you know, the character that we sort of developed and made was such an interesting one.
What was your first reaction getting the call to become Brixton, to step into the Fast and Furious Hobbs and Shaw universe?
I think my first reaction was like, yes, let's go for this. You know, I get to kick Dwayne's butt, I get to kick Jason's butt, I get to be part robot, I get to, you know, all this stuff. I really wanted to work with David Leitch. He's a great director, I really admired him. Atomic Blonde is a really great film, and I thought, you know, Deadpool 2. So I really wanted to work with this team, the great team, and yeah.
I knew that David was such an interesting filmmaker, and he'd done such great things with Atomic Blonde and Charlize and that, and I was super excited to meet him on that basis. And then he started talking about what he wanted and what kind of women he wanted in a very, very male universe, in that genre particularly. And it was that got me interested in, because I suddenly thought, I'd really love to try and create a female in this who is, you know. And we spent a long time every day talking about she can't be saved, she can't be rescued, she needs to have her own strength, she needs to have her own willpower in every way. And they allowed me to do that. So it was really, I felt lucky.
Tell me more about filming that incredible scene in the Ukraine. Like, you had that car action, you had that truck fight with Idris and Dwayne.
It's a great location. I mean, that whole sequence is, for me, my most memorable. You know, it really was the real scale of that high-tech sort of facility. You know, we're in the rock crawler, that we flip the thing upside down, we're skidding around in it, with, you know, Hattie's jumping from the thing. It's just a great sort of moment. And for these big sort of popcorn films, we need that sort of big jaw-dropping spectacle.
It was a big logistical puzzle, and I'll say, you know, we shot a lot of it in Northern England, in Doncaster, at an abandoned power plant, so there's a lot of in-camera stuff. A lot. Practical car mounts, actors on car rigs, Jason free driving with mounts on the car, like, it's crazy. And then the back of the truck is gimbal rigs on stage with, like, effects rigs. And so it was a great collaboration between special effects, practical stunts, and our visual effects artists that make that special.
It was a few days, actually. It's a big epic sequence. You know, I jump off my bike and land on the back, and then we go into this sequence. And we shot that for a few days. We had a camera going round us the whole time, really getting into those moves. And then, you know, some of it we shot on set, where I jump off the truck at the end there, no spoilers. But, you know, it was a real sort of big epic sequence.
It was amazing. I love that. It was one of my favorite fights. In fact, in the scientist thing where I take those guys out. It was my favorite day. I love that sequence. And I love that she was kind of getting herself out of her own situation rather than being rescued by the guys. They came to get her, but she had to save them.
Oh, she tears
awesome.
All sorts of ass in this movie. It's fantastic.
I'm so glad, because I really just want little girls to respond to it and be like, oh, you know, I can be like her, instead of watching their brothers go do it, you know.
Look after your sister.
Listen, I'll handle it.
The only way we survive is working together like a team.
How does it feel to finally have a daughter in the family?
Yes, isn't that great? And what a daughter.
Oh, wow.
What a fabulous daughter.
Especially that Ukraine sequence.
Yes, she's fantastic. And she was so fun. Everybody adored working with her. I could tell when I walked on the set that they'd been working together for quite a long time, and the atmosphere was so great. She was just funny and relaxed, and they adored her, and that was great. I loved to see that.
This is totally what they need in 9. They need you two in there,
yeah,
just a
absolutely.
Whole scene cleaning
me
up.
Me and Hattie, yeah, totally.
Are there any other members that you would like to see added to the Shaw family? because we still don't know technically how big this family is.
We
don't.
It seems
like there's a new member
every
movie.
You know, East End families can be quite big. Yes. I think it'd be great to find some rather appalling uncle somewhere. I had an uncle by marriage who was an East End gangster. It might be fun to resurrect someone like my Uncle George.
We need a whole girl gang, I think. I think there's a whole girl gang we could. And like one of my best friends is Elizabeth Debicki, so maybe I'll persuade her to come and
yes, please,
be part
Universal,
of it.
Please. Yeah. Please.
She'd be amazing.
Anyone could come in. We haven't seen the dad. We ain't seen, you know, we I was quite upset that we never got to sort of have Owen in this. I think he's a great staple in the Shaw family. You know, if we're very fortunate and we get to do another one, or you know, the thing about these movies, they can just branch out anywhere. They can take any characters out of the franchise. You know, I think, you know, Tyrese and Ludacris, they could have those two run away and do something. I mean, it's very easy to sort of dip into any of those worlds. They're all very defined characters. Any of the girls from the franchise would warrant a spin-off in any sense. It's just the fact that we got the first sort of bite of the apple.
You're in serious trouble.
That's an understatement.
Let's get old school.
When did you know that Hobbs and Shaw was going to be the first Fast and Furious spin-off?
Specifically, I would say at the end of, well, in the movie Fast 8, we have a sequence where we put Dwayne and Jason in a prison cell,
yes.
Right? And they start insulting each other back and forth. That day on set, while we were watching and just listening to them riff, and you know the crew is laughing, we knew that you know, that if we were going to do a spin-off, that was going to be the first step. We had talked about it with the studio for a very long time, probably since Fast 5. But that day on set was when everybody kind of looked at each other and said, if we're going to widen the Fast universe, this is the first step. This is how you do it.
I think we wanted, obviously, to strike out on our own. We wanted to make sure we were true to the DNA of the Fast universe with all the big set pieces and sort of the tone of the theme of family. But I think we wanted, again, to strike our own tone of, like, fun, comedy, brotherhood, and in sort of a different way. And really, you know, highlight the dynamic of these two great actors.
That means, yes, you have crazy, insane action sequences for sure. You also have characters acting with a moral code, and family is truly something that's important to them. The way that you make it through your obstacles are family. And then Dwayne and Jason, like, you've interviewed them today or at some point, I'm sure, and they're just so fast. And when you pit their characters against each other, it's a natural setup, by the way. You know, with Hobbs being kind of a big, tough, wants to bash through everything, and then Shaw being more stealth and sleek, wanting to. Once you get those characters going back and forth, and you add on top of it the actors who are doing it, and they just love to kind of one-up each other, it just was a recipe for comedy in a fast world.
You guys have to work together.
No way.
This guy's a real ass.
I'm Mike Reyes from CinemaBlend, and I'm what you call a champagne problem. Vanessa, thank you so much for taking the time out today.
Well, I love your website.
Oh, thank you. Well, we love you as well.
You look smart today, sir.
Oh, I love the shirt you're wearing here.
Hey, it's sunshine into the city, eh? We got to dress for that occasion.
But you know what's more of a problem? If you don't click subscribe below and then hit that bell to know when we're putting up new videos. So stay tuned to CinemaBlend, and we'll see you later.